What's going on, YouTube? This is Mitch Santona, and I'm here with a video review for War for Cybertron's Soundwave. Soundwave is a Cybertronian thing, but a cool-looking thing. Got a couple of nice, almost looks like fangs in the front, like almost like a scratching claw, like the scratching claw at you with that thing. And a little bit of a throwback to his, his old tape deck chest there, which is nice, very nice. Got the War for Cybertron patented purple light piping, this is painted on, just kind of coursing through him. And, and he's got four wheels and rolls. Yippee! So, very, very cool looking toy. So let me get the lineup here. Just did Megatron. And that's him next to Megatron. Here he is next to Optimus. And here is, running out of room here on my camera. Here is Bumblebee as well. So that is my War for Cybertron collection as it sits. I don't know if any more figures are being released for this. I sure hope they are. I heard rumors. I can't confirm them. I haven't done my homework. I apologize. I'm a sucky reviewer. But anyway, this is the review for Soundwave. And this guy, his character, on my tech spec, I give a 9 to. I love this guy in the game. If you, I loved actually fighting him. It was kind of, was an awesome boss fight. He kept deploying rumble and all kinds of audio weaponry he was throwing at you, so very, very cool in the game. I really did dig this guy's character, and I liked his voice as well. It was a throwback to the G1 voice as opposed to the movie voice, which I love Frank Welker's Dr. Claw voice. You know, the we've located the boy, that kind of crap. That's really cool. I just didn't like it in the movie. I thought he needed that metallic G1-y voice instead. But still, like I said, cool voice, but I don't know, off on a tangent again. Let's get on the mold. I give this mold an 8. It's very nice. Got a lot of nice sculpting in it. He's got like a nice little theme going here with the kind of like the ribs with the purple. It's like a lilac or a lavender color. Little splashes of it in his both modes, and it's very nice. But he does have a lot of nice sculpt. I do like this vehicle mode, even though it's just weird looking. But again, I like quirky weird things, so I think it's cool. And I think he looks great as a robot as well. So very nice. I give it an 8. The paint on this guy, unfortunately, I give about a 6 to. Now, I love Soundwave's colors, and I love his Generation 1 colors. I loved him. These colors are good. It seems like they kind of wash out, and it's not really coming out too well on the camera. It actually pops more on this camera, it looks like to me, than not on the camera, if that makes any sense. But the colors kind of wash out. I think there needs to be a little bit more contrast. That's the only thing I'd be looking for in this figure. I don't think they're bad, because I do like his color scheme. I just think like the blue and that lilac, like I was saying, that purple color, you kind of don't see that too much. I wish if that like popped a little bit more. Maybe if the blue was a little bit darker and the gray was a little bit lighter, maybe it would kind of just contrast a little bit more. I just think there's a little bit washout. So that's all on that. He looks good in his robot mode though. It isn't that bad. This alt mode, I give a 7 to. It's cool. I like it. I think it's a little plain on the top. I realize you can't have like a cockpit or anything, because technically they're not vehicles to be driven by any other race at this point in this stage in the, in the timeline. But I just think it's very plain up in here. It does have a little bit of sculpt, but not a lot. And I just kind of don't like that. Maybe just something a little bit to break it up. Maybe a nice big purple Decepticon symbol up there would have been cool. And maybe I could repro label that if I really got crazy. But other than that, it's cool. The transformation I'm going to do off camera, I give it a 9 because I really like it. And when I get back, I'll have him in his robot mode. Okay, so got him in his robot mode. And this guy is Very cool. He's very screen accurate. He's got that same proportion, I guess, if you will, as the rest of the War for Cybertron characters, which I tend to like. They're kind of heavy-legged. Some of them got kind of big midsections, especially like Bumblebee comes to mind. But it doesn't look bad. I mean, they look really hulking and menacing. Like, they've got some weight to them, and I do like that. I mean, he's a little deluxe figure, but he just looks brutish, and I do dig that about him. And of course, he's got his little gimmick here, which is you can open his. Let me flip that up. You can open this, and the little batteries come out, which are his guns. And I do dig his little guns because they're throwbacks to the obviously the Generation 1 guns, which are little batteries, so that transform into the things. Now, this thing I have a little bit of an issue with. I can't get this to really stay out unless I pull real hard, and that was very hard. But he's got his little, Generation 1 gun here, so I'll stick that in his hand. And away we go. So yeah, but the transformation back to that, it was really cool. It's actually kind of easy, but it's unique, and I liked it. It's quite satisfying. It's just different. It's a lot different than what you would expect. It looks like it would just want to unfold and be very basic, but it's kind of cool. Like when you, I like transforming him back because like the whole robot kind of like builds up this way, and then you got just the legs sticking out. But it's really, I don't know, it's cool. Robot mode, I give an 8.2. I think I like this. I do like it a lot. The feet kind of suffer a little bit. I'm not too big on them. They're just a little tad too big for my taste. They look too ski-like, if you will. I think if there's a way I could fold this panel up a little bit. Oh, I'm sorry. Well, look at that. I guess you can. Okay, so there is a way to fold the panel up a little bit, which I just found out on camera here. Again, I attribute that to my crappy reviewing skills. But yeah, I guess they're not as bad as I thought they were. So, all right, maybe I'll give him a 9 then. I gave it an 8, but he just gained a point that fast. That's how that happens on camera. Boom. Articulation, I give an 8. It's very nice. He's got a lot of nice posability in him. He can't spin his fists, which is kind of a shame, and his head is not on a ball joint. It's just on a swivel. So. But the rest of them, whoa, allergy blowout, excuse me. But the rest of them is, quite crazy. You can get nuts with them here. So I do like that, and he does stay in a lot of these poses as well too, which was a cool thing about Megatron too. They're both, you kind of put them in that weird pose and they stay. Okay, so let's get to quality control. This guy, unfortunately, I give a 6.2, and the only reason I give a 6.2 is because I had issues with this gun, and I could not get this to stay out without pulling it really hard. The first couple times I had to actually use tools to pull the thing out because it would not come out of this thing, and I was kind of upset with that. So I do have a little bit of an issue with that. He's got some improper cuts on these mold gates here. You were not degated correct. Well, I mean, they're just kind of a little bit sloppy, so I got, some jagged plastic. That's something I could go in and clean up, but I don't prefer to have to clean up my figures if I, don't have to. So, but I give it a 6. His paint apps and everything look really cool, but other than that, that's really about it. So rating overall, I give this guy an 8. I like Soundwave. I think he's cool. Soundwave's always been one of my favorite characters. You can see if you look through my old reviews, I got about freaking 8 Soundwave reviews already. And I always loved Soundwave. He was like my first big G1 character that I received when I was younger. I remember getting him for Christmas and absolutely flipping out. I knew it was a Transformer. I could tell under the tree we were always allowed to open one gift on Christmas Eve. It was just the rules. It was something we begged for. So, and I knew I felt all the packages up, man. I was shaking them, and I'm like, oh yeah, this one's got to be a Transformer. And I know it's a big one too because I can feel the package. And I opened it up. It was Soundwave, and I almost did a backflip. I mean, I could not. I think I slept with him that night. I mean, I could not put him down. He was one of my bigger Transformers, and I never had Megatron, so he always stood in as my bad guy default leader. So. I do have a love for the character. But yes, back to this rating on this guy, I do give him an 8 overall. I think he is pretty cool. I wish he was bigger. I wish I could get a Voyager out of this guy, but he's a great figure, so pick him up if you can find him.